శ్రీమాన్ వెంకటనాథార్య కవితార్కిక కేసరి వేదాంతాచార్య వర్యో మే సన్నిధత్తాం సదాహృది. నెక్స్ట్ ఇన్ ద సిరీస్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వేదాంత దేశిక విషయక స్తోత్రం టు కమమరేట్ స్వామి దేశిక 750th బర్త్ యానివర్సరీ. టుడే స్తోత్రం ఈ సప్తతి రత్నమాలిక. ఇట్ కన్సిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ 74 వర్సెస్ ఆన్ స్వామి దేశిక. 74 verses on Swami Desika, composed by Sri Prativati Bayangaram Annan Swami. Prativati Bayangaram Annan Swami occupies a very important position in our Sri Vaishnava Darshanam, in our Sri Vaishnava Acharyas. And he actually does not rank exactly with the regular line of Acharyas. But the importance of his position is because his son Nayanacharya was Prativati Bayangaram Annan Swami's Acharya. And he was also connected to the another contemporary Swami Manavala Mamani, who is the doyen of Tenacharya Sampradaya. So he is connected to both Vadagalai and Tenkalai Acharyas. And apart from the Abhipraya Bedam, there is hardly any difference between the two sects of Sri Vaishnava community. We both follow Ramanuja Sampradayam, Ramanuja Darshanam. We both have Pancha Samskaram. We both believe in Sharanagati, that Sharanagati Prapatti. And in the way how it is performed, and that's the nuances that we have subtle differences in the two sects. And according to the Guru Parampara and Swami Desika's son, Nayanacharya, is the one who took position of an Acharya of Swami Desika. And then he had one of his Shishyas, Acharya, our Prativadi Bayangaram Annan Swami. And Prativadi Bayangaram Annan Swami was in Srirangam as ordained by his Acharya. And he was in Srirangam at the same time. Manavala Mamunis and his disciples were also there. And the occasion for this arose when Swami was teaching all the Vedanta Desikas as he learnt from Kumara Vardacharyas in Srirangam, and it was going on in Srirangam temple. And Manavala Mamuni also with his Shishyas were in Srirangam. So that the teaching of Annan Swami, of course, obviously followed the traditional Vedanta Desikas and his predecessors up to Ramanuja. And when Manavala Mamuni was conducting based on what he had learned from his Acharyas and conducting his classes, and once there was a particular reference interpretation of Tiruvayamuri in particular, there was a differences of interpretation in certain points of Tiruvayamuri, and one of the disciples of Manavala Mamuni and Annan was having a discussion on the different interpretations and which one was the correct interpretation. So provoked by that, so Annan composed this work of 74 verses on Vedanta Desika called Saptati Ratna Malika. It's called the jewel garland malai, Ratna Mala, the jewel garland of 70 verses in praise of his Pracharyan Vedanta Desika, his Acharya's Acharya, describing his works, describing his teaching, describe how Swami Desika's shown so well through several Sri Suktis, and through his works propagating Ramanuja Darshanam in quite an unambiguous manner. And he recited it in the presence of Lord Ranganatha and putting it to the God himself, surrendering himself to disapprove of what is stated in the poem if he was wrong in the interpretation of Tiruvayamuri as he had put forth to the fellow Bhagavatottama. The story is that his appeal to the Lord Ranganathan met with God's approval and put the correctness of Vedanta Desika's teaching beyond dispute. And this became the reason for, and then of course Manavala Mamani had accepted Annan Swami as one of the Ashtadiggajangal, and he became one of the Shishyas of Manavala Mamani subsequently. And Prativadi Bhayangaram Annan Swami, it seems Manavala Mamani used to be highly respectful of Annan Swami, and in fact asked one, the Shishya who had actually had differences of opinion on the Tiruvaimuri, and who talked about Vedanta Desika Sri Suktis earlier, and asked him to seek forgiveness from Annan Swami and from Swami Desika's Divyamangala Vigraham, and he put the disciples back on track. So Swami Manavala Mamani used to consider Desikan as address him as Abhiyuktar. Such unity was and is and will be among the two sects of Sri Vaishnavas. So this 74 slokams of Saptati Ratnamalika, I'm not going to describe the entire stotram. We will only talk about the summary, as beautifully explained by and compiled by Tiruvallur Tirumalai Eechampadi Swami Ranganatha Acharyar in this book. And it talks about Swami Desikan's avatara prabhavam. Swami Desikan's avataram is Lord Tirumalai Srinivasan's avataram. It is parallel to the Lord's avatarams, incarnations. And in Purattasi Thiruvanam, he appeared as the Tirumani Alvar Amsham, the Vishnu Ghantavataram, as traditions record. And probably Ramanuja himself has appeared in order to clearly establish and propagate Sri Bhashyam. He appeared as Swami Desikan himself. So that's how it is told. In the 27 stars, there are only two stars which start with Tiru, Mahalakshmi, Tiru Onam, Tiru Adire. And these two are shared by the Acharyas, Swami Desikan and Swami Embirumanar Bhashyakara. Then it talks, the verse Saptati Ratnamalika also talks about Swami Desika's most auspicious attributes, the Kalyana Gunas and the Vaibhava. He always used to consider the Bhagavatas Paduka as to be held on to. And he had Jnanam, Bhakti, Vairagyam, Karunyam, sense control, Samatvam, considering everybody as equal, Dhairyam, Shanti, all those Kalyana Gunas were always with him. He never used to have Kamam, Kobam, jealousy, greed, confusion, cheating, cunning, deceit, and bragging about himself, boastful, those Heya Gunam he never used to have. So he had Ananta Kalyana Gunams as well as Agilaheyam, and he was like Vyasa Bhagavan in recitation of Veda Vedantams, and he learnt Kalpasutra Prayogams, he learnt Jyotisham, he learnt grammar, Vyakaranam, everything he had learnt, Puranams, Agamams, he had learnt. Alvas Sri Sukti, he had completely learnt, and he used to quote Alvas Sri Sukti in his Chilrai Ragasyams, and all his Sri Suktis he used to quote at most appropriately. Sankhya Yogam, Sankhyam, Yogam, Advaita Matam, Bauddham, Jainam, Shaivam, all these matams he had learnt in order to know the intricacies of those matams, the nuances of those matams, and then tell his opponents that this is what your madam says, right? He used to make them acknowledge the intricacies of their matams and then reject one after the other in Satadushani and other works of Swami Desikan. and he was called, he was addressed and conferred the title of Vedanta Acharyan by Ranganathan himself, by Ranganayaki Sarvatantra Swatantra, and such that was his glory. He was Vyakhyana Chakravarti, Kavitarkika Simham, and he had the complete all the qualities of Mahaguru, Acharya Sarvabhauman, and he had all the qualities of ultimate, simple, sincere Shishya. And Vedanta Desika Granthams, his Granthams are more than 120 works. And every one of his works is enough for us to get uplifted in this life as well as in our next life. And even one verse is adequate. And his Sri Suktis completely dispel our ajnanam, the darkness, the mode of darkness. And it grants us the enrichment of knowledge. That viparita jnanam goes away and the right jnanam comes into us, blooms into us. When you switch on the light, automatically the darkness gets removed. We don't say, oh darkness, please go away. The moment we learn or recite Swami Desikan Sri Sukti, it's automatic that the darkness gets away. And it grants us the ultimate redemption from our samsaric afflictions and tapams, grants us moksha, and it grants us the respect from the erudite scholars. And the Granthams are even celebrated by those who did not like Swami Desikan himself, who did not like the way he was spreading Ramanuja Sampradayam in a streamlined, structured manner, the likes of Appaya Dikshitar and others. And whatever that one needs to learn in the very many births, several ages, one can learn in few years by learning just Swami Desikan Sri Suktis, because he has compiled in such an essence form. There is no need to read anything else. Swami Desikan Adiyom Padiyom Ini Alvalake and Sadadushani Sarvarth Siddhi, all these things, if one learns, they can challenge the other religious or Avaidika people, and then they can conquer them effortlessly. We are not going to do that. However, it is possible to, when challenged, we can put forth the arguments in a crystal clear manner so that the opponents get defeated. And the importance of Desika Bhakti, those who are desirous of moksham and want to get rid of the samsaric afflictions and want no more this birth, death, vicious cycle, no more sorrows, grief, sorrow and sufferings, need to have bhakti on Swami Desikan. The way Ramakrishna avatarams were disliked by Ravana or Shishupala, there are people who do not like, who never used to like Swami Desikan during his time in the Vibhavavataram as well as in Archavataram. And that's because of his complete intellect and the scholarship and jnana bhakti vairagya anushtana. So, and because of that, there were people who were jealous of him. So even though if one possesses all good qualities, even though they do not have any defects in them, if they do not have bhakti on Desika, they do not get the grace of Ramanuja. There is no way moksham is for them. So Swami says here that bhakti on Swami Desika is essential for us to get saved. Swami Desikan Nadevam Desikat Param, because Swami Desikan explained in his Sri Suktis, in every Sri Sukti, in every line in Sri Sukti, it reverberates Emperumanar Swami, Emperumanar Sri Swami Bhashyakarar, whatever Ramanujas, Darshanam, Sampradayam, works, Sri Suktis, words, and the Vishishtadvaita Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya. And Swami Saptati Ratnamalika verses number 10, 59, 17, 65, 23, 55. These verses in the same order are recited after Desika Mangalam, which we enjoyed yesterday. It is recited in the Satumarai, which is none other than Bhadrapada Masagada Vishnu Vimalakshe Venkata Mahitrapati Ditta Dina Bhute Pradura Bhavajagati Daityari Bukhanta Hanta Kavitarkika Murgendra Guru Murtya Sasancha Lakta Ranjana Stodudra Pundra Manditaha Saganda Lakna Santulasya Narga Padma Malikaha Siddhantariya Suttariya Yajna Sutra Sohopitaha Mamavirastu Manase Gurusya Venkateshwaraha Ananta Suri Sunaye Vinadyamana Vaibhavat Digantavadi Hamsa Jitra Kala Mega Deshika Upatta Sarva Sasanaya Hanta Varsha Vimshatau Punaf Punan Namaskriyastu Venkatesha Shuraye Kavitarkika Kalabhaura Chakabali Krita Simmam Kamalapati Karunara Saparivartita Bodham Yadinayaka Padapankaja Yugali Paratantram Bhajamana Sabuddha Venkata Patideshika Manisham Kalaye Satatam Karuna Jalatim Karuna Vishayam Kamaladipate Kalivairi Shatari Vajorasigam Kavitarkika Kesari Suri Gurum Guravvadi Hamsa Budhajari Shishke Janabhakti Hina Yadindra Priyavi Syuhu Yadindra Priyavishnu Karunya Dhuraha Kutomukti Vatatrik Dhatrik Vidhana. And Vede Sanchatagede Munijana Vachane Prapta Nityavamane Sankirne Sarvavarne Sati Tadhanugune Nishpramane Purane Mayavade Samode Kali Kalusha Vasha Shunyavade Vivade Dharmatranaya Yobhut Sajayati Bhagavan Vishnu Ghantavataraha. And Swami explains so nicely in each of these stotrams how Swami Desikan Sri Suktis explained so nicely and how it is beautifully establishing Ramanuja's wonderful Sri Suktis in an unambiguous manner. And Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Namo Narayana Adiya Srimate Nigamanta Mahadeshikaya Namaha.